We're on day five. Today is day five of this little adventure. Cycle one, day five. I told you about day one. Day one was where they put Taxol chemotherapy in the chest port. And then day two, they put cisplatin in the abdominal port. And both those procedures went well, and there wasn't any pain or discomfort in it. But that was Wednesday and Thursday. But then Thursday night, when we got back to Johanna's, pain started to set in the bones, and that lasted Thursday night. And I was taking 600 milligrams of ibuprofen. But that wasn't really doing it at all. So that was Friday. I was still at Johanna's, and the children were trying to comfort me. Little Ian would come in and say, "Are you okay, Clammy?" And then Eric came in and he read to me, "Make way for ducklings and frog and toad." And then Michael would come in and talk to me about what he wanted to be when he grew up, which is a zookeeper. And Johanna was tending me, and I was very comforted by that. And then Friday, there's no chemo on Friday, so Harv and I drove home, and I was in a lot of pain Friday, all day Friday, and Saturday. It was bone pain. I've never experienced this kind of pain before that was lasted so long and was unrelenting. And all I could do was cry out to God and ask Him to help me. And I listened to some CDs. I have a very nice CD from our friend Meg Vanderhart. Her son Jonathan has a CD about it's him old time hymns that I really love. And so about Saturday evening, the Lord gave me wisdom that I was to call the doctor about it, and she said, "Well, I should be taking some hydrocodone." So I had to, because the pain level was around 7 to 8, pretty constant, and it wouldn't go down very much with the ibuprofen. So I took the hydrocodone, and an hour later, there was relief. I can't even explain it to you. It was such a relief. The pain, not all of it went away, but enough to make it so that I could function and sleep. And I can't explain to you. I don't know if I can explain to you. Maybe you've experienced it before. John Owen says, "Did you never run for shelter in a storm and find fruit which you expected not? Did you never go to God for safeguard, driven by outward storms, and there find unexpected fruit?" Well, I found unexpected fruit. I have found unexpected fruit throughout this whole situation. The Lord gave me such a blessing Saturday night and all day today. I am so joyful and happy and peaceful. And where is this coming from? It has to be coming from the Lord, and I know your prayers are helping me. You just don't know how much I appreciate your prayers. You'll never know how much I appreciate them. And so today there's no chemo, and then we have no chemo on Monday or Tuesday, but then Wednesday we'll go back down to Peoria, and I'll have Taxol pumped into the abdominal port, and then that's all the chemotherapy that I'll have for this 21-day cycle. And that will, at the end of 21 days, that will be the end of one cycle or one round. So that's what's going to be happening, and I want to encourage you in one thing. I would like you to do one thing. If you could practice trusting God today, practice trusting God. You know how some of us have a hard time trusting God? We have a lot of anxieties. Little things worry us. We go over and over and over details in our mind and fret about them. And I want you to practice trusting God. He is worthy of your trust. The way you practice trusting God is when you find yourself worrying about something, fretting about something, running to your anxieties like a magnet. Ask God to help you. Turn from those anxieties and get busy doing something else. You pray or you quote some scripture or whatever you need to do. Turn from the anxiety and practice trusting God. It takes practice because most of us are very, very skilled at practicing our anxieties. And I'd like you to practice trusting God. Will you do that for me? And we'll see you another time.